So friends, be alert, knowing only the journal name is not sufficient. Few of the research scholars have picked only the journal names from my previous videos, and unfortunately they submitted their research papers in the clone journals, the journals with the same name and same ISSN. So please go through this video, please go through these journals very carefully, especially about journal name, ISSN number, and importantly genuine journal homepage or website, and through that website only you have to submit your research article. So hello everyone, welcome back to the channel My Research Support. So today in this video I'll be discussing about total 13 fast publication unpaid journals. All these journals are Scopus and Web of Science Index and obviously comes under UGC CLEAR group 2. So publication duration of all these journals varies from 1 month to 5 months. This publication duration is calculated based on the recently published research articles in those journals, but obviously in few cases this publication duration may vary. I also tried to focus on multidisciplinary kind of journals, those can include maximum areas, but I still believe that I couldn't touch each and every area, and that is even not possible in a single video. So please comment me your area so that I'll take care of it in my next videos. And now onwards, we'll be also uploading a similar kind of videos on our Facebook page. I've given the link in this video description, so please do not forget to follow the page. Now let us start with Journal 1, which is Advanced Engineering Materials, Wiley Publisher. It comes under Scopus and Science Citation Index Expanded. This is a free journal, and I have mentioned this journal in one of my previous videos because recently I have published in this journal. Means I have published my review paper within the period of 2 months and my research paper within the period of 3 months. So if your research area is at all related to the materials, then definitely you can consider this journal for publication. So the next journal is Vietnam Journal of Science and Technology. So this is an interdisciplinary Scopus journal in the field of sciences and technology. This is the main homepage of this journal, and this journal accepts research as well as review articles, and this journal have mentioned 5 major streams. Okay, but still you have to refer to this journal description or aims part to get detailed idea about main topics and subtopics. Then you will get some details about the metrics of this journal. Site score, SGR index are comparatively low, but because of that only this journal accepts a comparatively higher volume of research papers, and your chances of getting accepted will increase. So it is still there from 2019, it is still there in Scopus. There are no author submission fees or publication charges. All costs for the publication process is supported by Vietnam Academy of Science and Technology. So I always recommend these types of journal, because as an author, even though this is open access journal, means your research article, if it is published, then it will be accessed freely to all, and because of that your citation score may increase. And you need not to pay this APC, means all these article processing charges will be beared by this Vietnam Academy of Science and Technology. And then we have referred many recently published research papers, so you can see that it is received date is 19 January and accepted in March, so it has taken 2 months. Second research paper May and published in July, so it has also taken 2 months. So there is a possibility that within 2 to 3 months this journal usually accept research articles. Now the third journal is Journal of Computational Social Science. So it comes under Scopus as well as Web of Sciences Social Science Citation Index SSCI. So even though it is mentioned about computational, but we found that it accepts almost all the fields of social sciences. This is the main homepage of this journal, and they have clearly mentioned about the areas like sociology, economics, political sciences, psychology, linguistic and other disciplines. So if your research area, you can refer this section for more details. And then about the journal metrics, impact factor is comparatively good, which is 3.2, and submission to first decision means whenever you will submit your research paper, within 12 days you will get to know about whether your research article is rejected or it is moving towards the revision process. And then publishing options, after acceptance the journal will provide you 2 options. First is traditional publishing model, means as an author you need not to pay any charges, but the viewers, those who want to download your research paper, needs to pay the subscription charges. Means most of the time this is subscribed by the universities by paying the fees, so university students will just read those research articles freely or download them. And open access, obviously for open access you have to pay, as an author you have to pay a very high, actually consider this fee is considerable. So I'll recommend you to go ahead with this. and we have referred few research, published research articles, March, May. So approximately it takes 2 to 3 months to accept your research articles. However, in few cases, we found a considerable time, maybe 6 to 7 months, but most of the articles are accepted during this period. Next journal, Asia Pacific Journal of Management. This is an interdisciplinary journal in the field of management. So it also comes under Scopus and Web of Sciences SSCI. This is the main website of Asia Pacific Journal of Management. So you can refer this aims and scope section where they have clearly mentioned about they generally accept entrepreneurship, human research management, international business, organizational behavior and strategic management. However, you have to refer to this also that these journals do not accept accounting, economics, finance, marketing and operations. And then about the metrics, this journal is also comparatively good, 5.4. Submission to first decision is a little fast, it takes 10 days. And publishing model is also hybrid, means you will be given 2 choices after acceptance. Okay, so we have to always go ahead with this choice so that we need not to pay any publication charges. Okay, so acceptance rate is generally not provided on the website main homepages of many journals, but on several other platforms it is available. So it is mentioned about 100%, but it is not always true, or it is not that much accurate, but we can still consider that the acceptance rate can be 70% or maybe 60 to 70%. So that is again considerably high. So the fifth journal is Multiscale and Multidisciplinary Modeling Experiments and Design. So this comes under Scopus as well as Web of Sciences ESCI, Emerging Sources Citation Index. So if your research area is at all related to any kind of modeling, experiments and design, then definitely you can consider this journal for submission. So this is the journal homepage. And you can stick to this aims and scope. So they have clearly mentioned about which areas they consider. So maximum areas basically are considered in this journal. And then about journal metrics, impact factor is good. The submission to first decision is very fast and publishing model is also hybrid. So we can go ahead with this model. And then submitted on January and accepted in February, within the period of 1 month. This article is accepted, and here December and March, it has taken something around 2 to 3 months. So this is a general period. You can consider 2 to 4 months are required. So the next journal, Behavioral Sciences and Law. This again comes under Scopus and SSCI. Behavioral Sciences and the Law. You can stick to this aims and scope. They have mentioned about abstracting and indexing part also. So this is about the metrics. Site score is little good and impact factor is 1.4, acceptance rate is 30%, and submission to first decision, which is mentioned as 48 days, but when we analyze recently published research articles, then it is in between 2 months to 4 months. Article processing charges. So this journal will give you an option to publish in open access, and that would be an option, so it would be your choice. So don't go ahead with this charge, otherwise you might have to pay this APC. Okay, and this is the published research article submitted November and February, so it is something around 3 months, second November and February, so this is again something around 3 months. 7th journal, International Journal of Bilingual Education and Bilingualism. So this comes under Scopus and Web of Sciences ASCI. This is the journal homepage, and aims and scope, you can refer to this: linguistics, sociology, psychology, education, law, women's studies, history, economics and informatics are included. So this journal also publishes this book reviews of up to 2000 words. Then this is about journal metrics. So this is a kind of good journal which comes under Q1 quartile, and impact factor is 2.8. So this is mentioned about the first duration and average revision period, etc. But actual acceptance rate lies in between 2 to 3 months. Acceptance rate is quite good, 27%. Publication charges, there are no submission fees or publication fees for this journal. So this is a free journal. You can see here, article is submitted on 14th March, accepted in May, within the period of 2 months, and then submitted on 14th December and accepted on 20th December. So it is even within the few days itself, this article is accepted. Next, research in social and administrative pharmacy. This again comes under Scopus and SSCI. This is the main homepage. You can refer to this aims and scope. So maximum fields or maximum areas of pharmacy are considered here in this journal. This is about journal metrics. They have mentioned about the timeline of first decision, revision, etc. Size score and impact factor for this journal is comparatively good. Okay. These are the subject areas: pharmacology, pharmaceutical sciences, public health and public policy. Then you will get more details about this metrics here. Okay, publishing options, you'll be getting two options. So we'll go ahead with this. Acceptance rate is also good. It is 21%. Okay, so here time for to publication, it is mentioned about 28 weeks. But when we analyze research papers, we found that it takes only 2 to 3 months. Okay, this open access option that you need not to go ahead with until and unless you have some institutional funding. This is a research paper which is, you can see, submitted on March and accepted in May. So it has taken something around 2 months. Then this is December and accepted in May. So it has taken something around 4 to 5 months. Ninth journal, Archives of Computational Methods in Engineering. So this is the interdisciplinary Scopus and Science Citation Index expanded journals in engineering. This is the main homepage of this journal. So refer to this aims and scope. So obviously this is an interdisciplinary journal, but it emphasizes on computational methods and computational study. So if your research area or if your research work at all consists of any computational kind of work, then only you can go ahead with this journal. Okay, so submission to first decision is 10 days and this is comparatively good journal which has 9.7 impact factor, which is a considerable one. And then you will be getting two options after acceptance. We can go ahead with this. So here again, it is not mentioned on their journal homepage, but on several other platforms you will find that it is mentioned about the acceptance rate, which is 40%. So we can consider that it is not that much accurate. So we can consider it is around 30%, up to 30% acceptance rate would be there. And this research paper submitted on January, which is accepted in April. So it has taken something around 3 to 4 months. Then December and March, this has again has taken something around 3 months. Next journal, Current Medical Science. It almost considers all the areas of medical sciences. So this is again Scopus and SCI journal. So this is the homepage, and this is a kind of interdisciplinary journal which consists of considerable areas. You can see the areas mentioned here. You can go through this aims and scope. Okay, so that you can just track or identify whether it consists of your area or not. Then about the metrics, submission to first decision 10 days. Impact factor is good, which is something around 2.4, and you will be getting two choices after acceptance. So you can go ahead with this model so that we can publish our research paper freely. Okay, the research paper submitted on 2nd December, which is accepted in February, it has taken something around 2 to 3 months. Then received on 18th May and it is accepted in the next month, so it has taken something around 1 month. Next, structural and interdisciplinary optimization. So this is an interdisciplinary journal in the field of sciences and technology. So this is Scopus and SCI journal. This is the main homepage, and this journal is really recommended because it mainly consists of many fields. But the only thing is, you have to see whether your research areas relates to the modeling, experiments, design. Okay, and for that it is recommended to go through these areas very carefully. And then impact factor is good, 2.2. Submission to first decision is only 6 days. And then after acceptance, we can go ahead with this option to publish freely. And on some other platforms, I found that it is mentioned about 90.9%. But still, we can say, even though the acceptance rate is in between 50 to 60%, still this acceptance rate will be comparatively high. So this is a good thing that we can go ahead with this journal. And the publication duration is also comparatively less. As you can see here, the April received date is April and revised date is May and accepted is July. So it has taken something around 3 to 4 months. Here also April and July. So within same period, this article is also accepted. 12th journal, Psychiatry, Psychology and Law, it comes under Scopus and SSCI. Okay, this is the main homepage. You can refer to this area. So many areas of this psychiatry, psychology and law is considered in this journal. So this is about the matrix. So Q2 as per the Web of Science quartile and Q1 as per the Scopus quartile. Okay, acceptance rate is comparatively good, which is 42%. Okay, they have mentioned about this acceptance duration and all. So we'll discuss this while discussing the published articles. Publication charges, there are no any submission or publication fees. It is clearly mentioned. The article which is submitted in January, which is accepted in May. So it has taken something around 4 to 5 months, and February it is accepted in April. It has taken something around 2 months. And the last journal is Social Science Quarterly, an interdisciplinary Scopus and SSCI journal in the field of social sciences. This is the main homepage of this journal. You can refer to this section, Aims and Scope. And on some other platform, it is mentioned about 85.7% acceptance rate. But we can say it may be around 50 to 60%. Still, this percentage is very high. Okay, so that is a good thing. And then they have mentioned about there is no any submission charges. So this is free basically, no, you won't find any publication charges. And then it takes something around 4 to 5 months or maybe 3 to 5 months. Okay, on 12th December it is submitted, accepted on 25th February. So it has taken something around 3 months. In this case, 7th September and February, it has taken something around 4 to 5 months. So thank you very much for watching this video. So friends, even though I have conveyed you this list of journals, but at the time of submission of your research paper into any of these journals, you have to just analyze the status of that journal, because there are many journals those have changed their status from subscription category to open access. Means previously they were accepting these journals in subscription category as well as in open access category, but later they have converted to open access only. Means in that case, after acceptance, you have to pay the article processing charges, then only you will be able to publish your research article. So these are the points that you need to be taken care of, and please also update that information through comments, so all of us will get benefited. So please do not forget to subscribe this channel and follow us on Facebook. So I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.